everyone. My name is Nella, and I'm a customer success specialist here at Naviant. Today, we're going to be talking about FlexiCapture, best practices, and troubleshooting. FlexiCapture is enriched in classification and data extraction technologies that are easy to configure and maintain. Now, let's talk about our agenda. In this video, we'll review some best practices using Project Setup Station, the Scanning Station, and the Verification Station. We'll then review some troubleshooting tips in the Administration and Monitoring Console. And this video is meant to give a quick review of these applications to provide some easy tips for users and admins alike. If you have any questions specific to your solution, please reach out to support@naviant.com. To start us off, we have Project Setup Station. This application is used by administrators to configure and make changes to projects. A project signifies document definitions, batch types, and other processing options. When configuring document definitions, if you want to enhance lookups for users, it's highly recommended to utilize datasets. Datasets not only help users by having the necessary information, but also keeps track of this information within its own internal database. If these tables can be scheduled to update periodically, users are consistently up to date. If the information is not configured to update automatically, there are multiple ways to update this info. This can be done directly within Project Setup Station or with the use of scripting. This can be helpful, and if the database ever goes down, the updated information is natively accessible within FlexiCapture. I've also mentioned the Project Setup Station is used to configure batch types for projects. Batch types need to be configured in Project Setup Station first before moving into the Scanning Station to create a batch type. This can be done by selecting the Projects tab. Without setting them up here first, there will be no batch type to link to batches created in the Scanning Station. Speaking of the Scanning Station, this is where documents can be imported into the system, whether there is a paper, digital, or any other type of document. When creating these batches, also make sure that you're conscious of what you name them. For example, if a batch type will be used in the Scanning Station, add anything to indicate that this batch type is used for scanning. For example, invoices with the word scanning in brackets, as opposed to used for the Project Setup Station, it could be named something like invoices with the project in the brackets. This helps users to avoid confusion about using the correct batch type. Next up, we're talking about Verification Station. The following best practices for utilizing the Verification Station are also considered troubleshooting tips too. Let me show you what I mean. Here we have a list of queues sitting in the Verification Station. Notice here, this button is selected at default after launching the application. If a user forgets this is the default, they may ask, why can't I see any batches? If the user selects the button to the right of the default selection, you're then able to view all the working batches. When looking through the list of working batches, think about this next tip. By default, the list is shown as a detailed list. However, if we select the button to the left, we get a thumbnail view. This allows users to easily scroll through and visually preview each batch before selecting Get Task. Speaking of the Get Task action performed on these batches, we want to make sure we're utilizing this Get Task button. The Get Task action locks documents so users can make changes and successfully apply these changes without someone else working on the same document at the same time. This prevents duplication and corruption. Also, if I were to double-click on a batch and try to make any changes, I'll receive an error. And this is because I double-clicked instead of selecting the Get Task button at the top. If you can't remember if you double-clicked to view the batch or not, you can look at the button next to Get Task, and if the Close Task button is available to click on, you have successfully locked that batch, and now you can make the necessary changes. The last application I'd like to talk about is the Administration and Monitoring Console. This is a web-based application used for setting up ABBYY FlexiCapture and monitoring its operation. Once you're here, there's a section for available web stations. Scanning and verification stations can be accessed through the web if users are unable to access the server. This was helpful to users when COVID forced people to work from home. Some users were unable to connect to the server, but they were still able to accomplish work using the web-based applications. If we select Administration and Monitoring Station, we can see a horizontal menu at the top of the screen. Here, I want to visit the setting tabs first. Here you can make changes to projects, users, or user group settings. In this screenshot, it's showing the groups tab where changes can be made to groups and their permissions. Below that, you can access information about the application server, SMTP settings, and any event logging and cleanup configuration. This screenshot shows the event logging mode and the events configured to be logged. Speaking of event logging, if we navigate to Process Monitor and select Event Log, we can see information that's been logged for each project. If you're troubleshooting an issue, you can toggle the list to show an error message only. There's also a button with the plus sign that can be used to search and filter through the logs collected. This can be helpful if you're receiving errors or troubleshooting a process that's misbehaving. And before we finish up, I want to talk about some quick tips to remember if you ever get stuck when working within scanning, verification, or project setup stations. When you hover over any button, it gives a description for what the button is and the shortcut associated. If you're consistently using these shortcuts, you could accomplish everything without even leaving your keyboard. And if you want to edit a shortcut, options are available to customize those. Another tip is utilizing the question mark when you see it. After clicking the question mark, the cursor has a small question mark next to it. I can then select anything to access a pop-up window with the ABBYY FlexiCapture documentation. This documentation can also be found by navigating to Help and selecting Help Topics. There you can search for what you're looking for. For example, if we use the question mark cursor to select something like document separation, the pop-up window opens and jumps to the documentation regarding the batch type settings and document separation. These records cover everything you need to know to utilize the software. This includes definitions, setting descriptions, and configuration documentation. I also want to point out that FlexiCapture has capabilities to configure scripting. FlexiCapture supports a variety of scripting languages such as C#, Visual Basic, and JScript. Scripts can be used at the scanning level, verification level, and pretty much everywhere to export and edit data. The script editor allows admins to create their own functions and procedures. This capability can help customize a solution that can really benefit users when utilizing FlexiCapture. And the last tip I have to share is customize your view when working within batches. You can move sections around to help you identify documents and configure them quicker. For example, I could leave this as default with the document preview and field verification at the bottom, or I can drag the gray header to the right side of the screen and it changes the view. I can also drag it to the top and it changes the view again. Additionally, any changes that are made are saved to the user's profile. This means when the user logs back in, these changes remain the same after exiting FlexiCapture. In summary, we talked about some best practices to help FlexiCapture users utilize the software to the best of their ability. We discussed some capabilities such as the view of the windows that could cause users to experience unexpected results. We then covered how to access event logs for use of troubleshooting errors or unusual behavior within the processes. Finishing up this, we discussed some quick tips when using and configuring FlexiCapture. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. And again, if you have any questions, please reach out to support at support@naviant.com. Thanks, bye.